I picked up the pot roast dinner thing from the slow cooker kit from Walmart by Tyson. You can do it yourself and buy like a roast and potatoes and your carrots, but like I just like to, I feel like this is cheaper and it's just easier because it's all in one little package. So I'm gonna start off by putting about 2 cups of water in my Pyrex dish. You really don't need much to go in the bottom of the crock pot. And then I'm gonna use my Better Than Bouillon beef paste. And I'm just gonna do like a tablespoon in the water and mix it up. Put that in the bottom of the crock pot. And now for this next part, I'm going to combine my dry seasonings in a bowl, which is the seasoning that comes with the pot roast. And then I have black pepper, I have basil, I have onion powder, I have garlic powder, and I have seasoned salt. And I'm gonna put it in a bowl. Then we're gonna rub down the roast. I'm gonna go ahead and start heating up my crock pot. I'm gonna put it on high while I do this. And for some people, the seasoning in the pack might be enough, but I like to do my own little thing. So I'm gonna add in the black pepper. And I'm gonna add in my garlic powder. I'm gonna add in my basil. This is just herb, so just the essence in there with it. And then I'm gonna get my onion powder. I'm gonna do some seasoned salt. And then I'm just gonna give it a mix. And this is how it looks in the bowl. So now I'll be right back. I'm gonna glove up and we're gonna rub it down. All right. Now you're gonna take your meat scissors and open up your roast. Please have on an apron and gloves for this part, touching raw meat. And you're gonna take it out of the pack. And I just like to use the tray that the little kit comes with. Like this is, you know, the little plastic tray. I'm gonna throw it away anyway. And I'm just gonna take my seasoning. Just that way y'all can see me. Yeah. I'm gonna take my seasoning and just pour some on the top and just save about half for the other side. And I'm gonna take my hands and I'm gonna rub it in to make sure that the roast is covered. And like you can scoop it up or slide the roast over just to make sure you get all of it. Do the other side and just use all the seasoning. And just continue to rub it down. And it's just beautiful. your meat is coated how you like it. Just make sure it's rubbed out. Just place it in the crock pot. Throw your carrots and your celery in there. I like to dice up my onion and my potatoes just because I have, you know, 5-year-olds, so they don't really eat whole potatoes. And it makes it stretch a little bit, I feel like. I mean, you still have the same amount, but I just feel like this makes it more plentiful. These are pretty. That's another reason why I like these, because like turn out the ones that's in the bag don't ever be this vibrant. I'm just not buying the whole time. So I'm just gonna quarter these. My onion, I'm just gonna quarter as well, because I like chunks. I just make sure that I peel it apart as I put the pieces in. And I'm also gonna add some garlic. I got this huge thing at Costco. I'm just gonna put that in there. Put garlic in there. Let that cook. I want to do mushrooms, but like I'm the only one who likes mushrooms, so no mushrooms. And so I'm gonna let that cook on high for about 2 hours, and then I'm gonna turn it down to low. So right now it's like 140. We just got out of church and ate lunch. So 341. Around 4 o'clock, it should be done. So the rest of it, I'll just let it stay on warm or low if I feel like I need to cook any more. And then later around 4, when everything finishes, or around 5, I'm gonna make homemade cornbread, sweet yellow cornbread. And we have the carrots and the potatoes, so I think I'm just gonna leave it at that. I'm not gonna make any greens or anything. So I'll show y'all how to make the cornbread, and then dinner will be ready. All right, y'all, I'm back. So now I have to make the cornbread. We're gonna use the Martha White yellow cornmeal mix, some flour, some sugar,
So I still have this on high because my roast wasn't done cooking. So I'm gonna do about I'm gonna do 2 cups of cornmeal. I'm gonna try to open this where it's not like a huge opening. Yeah, I'm gonna do 2 cups of this. It said one little pad, but I just want to make sure I have enough. So 2 cups. I'm gonna do a cup of flour. A 1/4 cup of sugar and a teaspoon of salt. I really just eyeball my salt. I'm just gonna take my whisk and like mix the dry ingredients. Okay, now we're gonna do a cup of milk. I'm just gonna melt the rest of this butter in the microwave. Or vegetable oil, I like butter. 2 large eggs. How much melted butter I have, and then you can stir it or whisk it. I'm just gonna whisk it. I'm gonna combine the two.
have that in the oven. And then this is how. Roast is cooking. Delicious. Y'all, I made a fresh flower arrangement myself this weekend, and I just love like the natural fragrance it brings, and just like the simple beauty it brings to like the room. It just looks so good, and I just feel like I had winter colors, like with the dark purple and the light purple. I just loved it. So I did like the 3 for $12 at Publix, and I just put it together myself, and I just like the way it looks. So it is like 6 o'clock. The cornbread should be ready around 6:30, so we should be eating around that time.